Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is part of the Ubiquiti UniFi Access range, the door access control system. This is the UA-G2-SK, so the UniFi Access Generation 2 starter kit. So I'm going to show you what you get in the box. There's quite a lot you get in the box. Guys, this is not a technical overview. There is quite a lot of documentation and quite a lot of things to understand about UniFi Access, plenty of other videos around that. But basically, you use one of these setups per door if you are wanting to create control for unique doors. There are other ways of having multiple doors connected to one of these, but they would all unlock at the same time. So this is the basic end of the starter kit, the Generation 2. So let's walk through what you are going to get in the box. So to start with, in true Ubiquiti fashion, you are going to get your installation guide. Ta-da! It is just a QR code. And again, white, not sure it's going to show up. Just a couple of little diagrams to remind you this is all PoE powered. So you will need an OS console to run this. It runs on the UNVR, the UNVR Pro, the UDM Pro, the UDM SE, the CloudKey Gen 2 Plus, and I think it will run on the UDR, the Unified Dream Router as well. But you will need the controller running on there to make all of this work. And you do need plenty of PoE++ power, I believe, 802.3bt to power this. Right, so what else are you going to get? You're going to get your little conformity pack that probably never ever comes out of its little plastic wrapper. All right, let me just move these things along the desk as we work through these. Now, you're going to get a myriad of things to mount all of these. So we're maybe going to do this device at a time, but let me show you the key bits. You're going to get a packet of screws and lugs because there are a number of devices to fix to the wall or your door surround. You're going to get a second packet here as well as you can probably see here, the quick release tool to allow you to disconnect this from the mount. That'll be the G2 reader, which we'll have a look in a minute. And you're going to get another packet of screws and lugs as well to mount the rail for the hub. So let's now look probably as we go along and a little bit at a time because most of these relate to it. So let's have a look. This is the G2 reader. All right, slightly upgraded from the previous one that we have had. There's no LED. There's just a light that shows at the bottom whether it's active or not. All right, and here on the back, I don't think there's anything to show you on the side. Here on the back, very simple. Here is our Ethernet in. This is PoE powered. All right, and the idea is this is going to be reset in a wall, and this is going to be on the outside of your property. And as a person comes up, they're going to use a card, which we'll show you in a minute, that you can swipe against this, and it's going to choose whether they can access that door and unlock it or not. All right, so if you imagine we have this, we now have a myriad of how are we going to mount this. So firstly, we get a guide that's our basic. You've got a level on there and our basic entry points for screwing this in place, which will fit this metal shield to start with. So if you're just going to be able to take a small recess out, then that's going to go into place like that. You're then going to bring the reader into place here. It's going to clip into that like that, as you can see, neatly into your door. Behind the door, I'll just show you here, you are going to have a bung that comes with this. So once you've got your connector or you pass your cable through here, put this in place here, and that will just create a seal around that, which should just give you a little bit of extra protection for the cable as it goes in through the wall. That would probably be the simplest place of mounting, but we then do have some backplate options. We have a metal black backplate here that again can go onto the wall, all right, and we can then, if we like, mount this onto our plate as another option, all right. So maybe we've got something previously in place, and now we can put our reader into here as well, all right, and that gives us this. And we have now a surround that can go then neatly over the top of all of that. Let me just see if that fits in that way. So you'd take that in. So you're going to take those two pieces like this, going to put your plate over the top, and then you're going to clip your reader in place. And if I didn't show you, the quick release button is at the bottom. You get the tool to actually do that as well. So that could be your the full setup, if you want to, of your reader neatly put in place. So that really covers all of the main portions there for the actual reader and the options that go with it. All right, there is another guide there for the other backing plate if you need it as well. Then we have, let's just have a look at the cards. You get 10 access cards in that. They come in these paper wallets. If you take them out, not really much different to that. All right, so obviously this is the idea. These are set up inside UniFi Access. The person is keyed to it who has access. As they come up, they tap this and it unlocks the door for them. So you're gonna get 10 of those in the pack. All right, and then you come down to the hub itself. All right, so the hub is the heart of this. This is all of your 12 volt wiring. This is all your wiring is gonna go to your door locks, your mag locks, everything else. This is PoE powered. So up on the top here, we have our PoE in. This is gonna come from your PoE switch, your UDMSE if you've got it built into it, all right? And that's gonna be your power and your network connection. Then this is gonna operate, if you like, as a small switch, and it's all unique to this device, all right? So you've got four PoE ports along the top here. You're gonna have your card reader here is gonna be connected to one of those. There are options for other door intercoms. You might choose to have one of these on the inside of the door instead of a push button. You can have the option to add in some cameras and connect some of the activities as well to unlocking the door or identifying. And then obviously you have all of your terminals here. And really this is where your imagination runs wild. This is down to your electrician and you and your understanding of how you can connect the doors together. I've seen plenty of people connect multiple doors to the same one of these hubs. As long as they're happy that once it swipes, it unlocks all of them. A push bar to on the inside to automatically unlock all doors. So there's quite a lot of versatility you can do with this hub, but it is the core of it all. You're then gonna get a DIN rail or a mounting rail, and that mounting rail obviously is gonna be fixed to the wall, and then it just clamps into place, wrong way around, Paul, clamps into place here, all right, and that holds that device, and that's obviously gonna be hidden inside your door frame or your surrounds or in a box next to your door. So like I said, there's a lot of components here. This is the basics. So in this generation 2, you're gonna get your hub, you get your G2 reader, all right, and you get 10 access cards. That should get you going. You're gonna need your door exit. You can add on other readers and everything else like that from the range, but hopefully that's been useful to at least show you what you get in the box. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless network and firewalling, how to set up UniFi Network, UniFi Protect, UniFi Access, all of those types of things. So please do subscribe and stay up to date.